'Twas the week before Christmas and all through the school.
Not a student was stirring, everyone following the rules.
The stockings were hung by the mural with care,
in hopes that Tommy Santa soon would be there.
Children were nestled all snug in their seats, frequently checking their phones to get all the deets.
Miss Hamilton in her kerchief,
and Mr. Martin in his cap, had just settled a student in for a nap.
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, Cheryl jumped from her desk to see what was the matter.
Away to the window she flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash.
The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to the objects below.
When what to her wandering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
With a little old driver, so furry and fat, I knew in a moment it must be Tommy Cat.
More rapid than eagles, his courses they came.
And he whistled and shouted, woo, and called them by name.
Now Carter, now Curtis, now Taylor and Green, on Gopi, on Goki, on Robert and Eugene.
To the front of the lawn, to the theater hall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away.
As the snowflakes that gather on the front walkway fly when they meet with an obstacle mount to the sky.
So up to the school roof, the coursers they flew, with the sleigh full of treats and Tommy Cat too.
And then in a twinkling, we heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof.
As I drew in my hand and was turning around,
down the chimney Tommy Cat came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot,
and his clothes all tarnished with ashes and soot.
A bundle of jeans he flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack.
His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses. His nose like a chin.
His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as snow.
A culinary cookie he held tight in his teeth as Jerry cleaned the crumbs falling beneath.
He had a green face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, or a jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself.
A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon had me knowing I had nothing to dread.
He spoke not a word but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk.
And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle.
But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight,
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night!
I forget my line.
I'm gonna butcher this.
The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow.
Totally forget.
What am I shouting? Just shout.
Woo!
Okay.
You're gonna start. I'm gonna start at the you end to reach the end of the
okay.
Group.
All right.
Right now?
Yeah.
Wait. No.
You got this.
Okay. To the front of the lawn, to the theater wall.
So, up to the
school
roof.
Bang.
Oh,
God.
Can't even do that.
Right. No, we can't.
Let's do that again. I hate being on camera.
Biggest show off in the league.
Quiet, I'm a sack!
Oh, my goodness.